Viewer discretion is advised.
There is no music in the background because I have something serious to discuss. If you guys have been long-time stairs viewers of this channel, then you probably know my life story. You probably know my wacky adventures, my story times, going from all the way back from middle school. But today, this is the last time that I'm going to be telling this story, and then I'm not going to bring it up anymore. I'm not going to answer any questions. I'm not doing that. So you guys know the story about my number one fan, right? About the incident that happened on June 24th, the exchange. And it was a big punch to the gut and also a big punch to the mouth because it's tough. It's tough just bringing this back up even a year later because you can't be doing nothing but just be silent on it and just learn a life lesson from it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what I did that was wrong because they're acting like that I committed a crime. They're just trying, you know, people like this, they're just trying to break you down, trying to like blackmail you and like keep this in the house and then bring it up when you're no longer seeing them. You know what I'm saying? And they just use it against you, even during your cancellation party, like the TXP is over party, you know, something like that. That's tough. And, you know, I honestly didn't care. You know what I'm saying? I just moved on from it because I didn't stress over it. For the first time in my life, I didn't even have to stress over a situation like this. You know what I'm saying? An exchange like this. Because now at age 20, you know, you get into, you know, kinds of stuff that you couldn't even get out of as a kid. You know what I'm saying? You could get away with. But that's besides the point. You know, getting pressed by somebody or having somebody turn on you, it's a life lesson. It shows the red flags because it shows that you're not loyal at all. You're not loyal at all. And that's harsh reality. So you know what I did? I moved on. You know what I'm saying? The fan moved on and we went our separate ways. You know what I'm saying? I'm starting to think that their friends are starting to turn against me too. Like they're going to bring this up probably a few years from now, a few months from now. But I'm not going to answer any questions because I washed my hands with this situation even a year later. You know what I'm saying? Ever since I was 14, I've always dealt with situations like this. You know what I'm saying? When somebody turns on me. But if this would have happened while I was in school, like earlier, it's like 8th grade, 9th grade, I'll be stressed and I'll be crashing out. I ain't going to lie to you because you have to see those people again. You know what I'm saying? At school. And then there are going to be a lot of narratives, a lot of questions, you know what I'm saying, that you're going to have to answer. And then it goes to the principal or the guidance counselor. And that's something that I don't want on my conscience. What am I talking about? What exactly am I talking about? I'm out of school. Like, that's something I wouldn't want on my conscience is what I meant to say. But the point is, you have to look for somebody who used to be like real with you. You know what I'm saying? Used to be cool with you. And then they turn on you for whatever reason or whatever that person is saying. It sucks. But it's a life lesson. They're not loyal. They're fake. And they're just, you know, just being mean for whatever reason. Leave those people alone. Don't even try to, you know, interact with those people. Let them be petty, because it's going to come around, going to turn around, and it's going to affect them in the long run. And then they're going to be alone, and they're going to rely on you to say, hey, how you doing, and all that. They're going to write this long apology, and you're just going to have to read it. You're just going to leave them on read like they did you. Because I know life is about second chances, and I don't take second chances for granted at all. But you got to learn from your mistakes. And that's what I did. You know what I'm saying? But there's always these narratives. Always these narratives about you. And people are going to be talking about you until the day you die. And, you know, as a bad boy, as, you know, this alpha male, you got, sometimes alphas got to be humbled sometimes. And this was a humbling experience. But then you got to pick yourself back up and keep on rolling. Now that it has been a year, I'm happy where I'm at. I don't need to please anybody. I don't need to answer any more questions about this topic, because wash my hands with it. Threw in the trash. It's in the archives. I'm done. Move on. Life goes on. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Stay safe.